Hello everyone, this is Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And in today's video, we're going to be creating our own function, a function for the area of a rectangle. Now, as you know, the area of a rectangle is the length times the width. So let's create a function for that. First, def, and we're going to define our function as rectangle underscore area. Now remember, there's two different parameters or two different variables that go into calculating the area of a rectangle. That's a length and a width. So what exactly is the area? Well, the area is going to be the length times the width. And if this function tells us what the area of a rectangle is, we want to return that area. So there's our function for the area of some rectangle. So if I want to calculate the area of, let's say, my first rectangle that has a length of 4 and a width of 2, I'll call that area A. And that's going to be equal to, I'm going to type my function and then type in those parameters of 4 and 2. So now area A is going to be what my function returns. It's going to hold that value of 8, which is going to happen to be an integer since my parameters are integer inputs. Let's calculate the area of another rectangle. Let's say I have a rectangle of length 5 and width 3. So area A, 4 times 2 should be 8, and area B, 5 times 3 is going to give us 15. But if I want to see them, let's go ahead and print them out. So we'll print area A, and we'll go ahead and print area B. And there you have it. All you have to do is enter in your different parameters for length and width, and it's going to output that area because that's how we've defined our function. But quickly, let's think about a square. Well, we can simplify this function down significantly because a square, each side is the same length. So really, as opposed to a length and a width, we only really need one parameter, just a side. And that's when we're calculating the area of some square. And the area is just going to be our side squared. Now to simplify even further, as opposed to naming a variable area and then returning that area, we can simply just return side squared to make this a more concise function with less code. So let's go ahead and see if I were to find this area of some square, let's say that has a side length of 6. If each side length is 6, 6 times 6, that length times width is my area, which should give me 36. So that's how you create a function for the area of a rectangle or a square. And that wraps up this video. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.